I be getting to the money. Everybody mad. Think I'm getting too much money. Everybody mad.
What's up, Wealth Babe? Welcome back to my channel. Be sure to check out the description box below so that you can have a chance to enter the 500 subscriber milestone giveaway. You can enter for a chance to win $50. If you are new, welcome to the channel. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and also click the bell to turn on post notifications so that you don't miss out on any wealth building content. You can also enter the giveaway. Just check out the description below to see how you can enter. And without further ado, in today's video, I am going to talk about exactly what the S&P 500 is, or the Standard & Poor 500. So let's go ahead and jump right into the video. So the S&P 500 is a market capitalization weighted index, and it is inclusive of 500 of the US's largest publicly traded companies, and it is widely known as the best gauge of the large cap stocks in the market. Now, there are other indexes. We did talk about the Dow Jones Industrial Average, also known as the Dow 30, on this channel. So I will link that video in the cards above if you haven't already checked that out, so that you can learn about the other index. And there is another index called the Russell 2000, which is inclusive of 2000 companies. I don't want to go into too much detail because this is specifically about the S&P 500, but I say that to say there are other indexes, but the S&P 500 is widely known as a great gauge for the large cap stocks. So large cap refers to a company that has a market capitalization over $10 billion. And how you would get to the capital or the market capitalization number, what you would do is multiply the company's outstanding shares, so the number of shares that they have available for the market to purchase and sell, multiply it by the price per share. And if you multiply that, those two factors, then you will arrive at the number of their market capitalization. Again, if it's $10 billion or more, it's a large cap company. Now, the large cap companies that are in the S&P 500 are primarily in the financial and the technology sector, and they make up other sectors that are leading industries within the US. Now, although the companies that are within the S&P 500 are chosen based on its market capitalization, so large cap stocks or large cap companies, the other determining factor for companies that get chosen is based on the company's liquidity, which pretty much means that the shares can be purchased and sold without pretty much or necessarily affecting the share price of the company's stock. Now, although most of these companies are US equities, that's not to say that the companies within the S&P 500 aren't headquartered or may have been incorporated within other countries. So the S&P 500 index is a largely regarded and widely quoted index. And again, the reason being is because the amount of companies that are within the S&P 500, the index is said to reflect the risk and return of the large cap companies within the index. And the other thing I'll say is that I think I mentioned this earlier as well, it's widely regarded as a representation of the US economy because of the amount of stocks or companies within the actual index, whereas the Dow Jones Industrial Average is just 30 companies, the S&P 500 has 500 companies. So the criticism about the S&P 500 is pretty much that the stocks within the index, if they become overvalued, then it will inflate the overall value of the index. Meaning, if there are shares or there's a particular company that has shares that are way overpriced, more overpriced than they should be, then the actual S&P 500's index will be inflated. That's it for now, Wealth Babe. Comment below and let me know which index you prefer. Is it the Dow Jones Industrial Average or is it the S&P 500? Comment below and let me know. Don't forget to check out the description box below to see how you can enter the 500 subscriber milestone giveaway for a chance to win $50. I will be announcing the giveaway winner on Monday, July 6th. So stay tuned for the video that gets released on the channel on Monday. And as always, please remember that if you're not fully, truly, and totally committed to building wealth, then chances are you won't. Mwah.